Hello everyone, welcome to Under Visits. In today's video, we'll be discussing about the ending of Jumanji, The Next Level. In the second installment of Jumanji, the gang are back in the magical world of the video game. This time, however, there are some extra people in the team, as Spencer's grandfather and his mate Milo accidentally get sucked in the game in the bodies of Dr. Smolder, Bravestone and Mouse Finbar. They are first left with Fridge and Martha in the bodies of Dr. Shelley Auburn and Ruby Roundhouse. These two are pretty concerned about how they will get through to their elderly mates, while also looking for their mate Spencer, who turns out in the body of Ming. They find her, but things are still complicated as they have no idea where their friend Bethany has got to, as she is not in one of the avatars. In the real world, Bethany is enlisting the help of their friend Alex, who comes back as Seaplane and brings Bethany as the avatar of a horse. Eventually, after fighting off various animals, driving down buggies through the deserts and arriving at a castle in the snowy mountain, the team know they need to swap bodies so they can properly help each other. Bravestone is back as Spencer, Auburn is Bethany, Mouse is Fridge and Ruby is Martha, while Ming takes on the person of Eddie and Milo heads into Bethany's horse avatar. Eddie and Milo are captured after the gang is forced to save their elders before they try to save Jumanji and end the game. With Seaplane heading to the stable to take care of the horse, meanwhile, Bravestone and Ruby head to the dungeon to get Ming, while Mouse and Auburn are on distraction duties in the castle. The antagonist of this level, Jurgen the Brutal, is ready to meet his bride, with Ruby saving the day and arriving in time for a quick dance fight. Eventually, Jurgen is defeated by Bravestone and Ming, and his horse fly up into the sky to save Jumanji, signaling the return of Nigel Billingsley to the endgame. Milo opts to remain in the game as his real-life body is suffering from illness, meaning he will have a longer, freer life in Jumanji than anywhere else. The others return to the world and meet up at Nora's for some dinner. This has added memories for Eddie, who used to run the restaurant with Milo, which was at the center of their fallout. However, things are clearly not over for the world of Jumanji, as the final scene sees the teenagers leaving the restaurant to find animals running past the doors and those frightening drums back in play. But what does this final frame mean? Those who remember the original Jumanji starring the late great Robin Williams will remember the game took place in the real world with animals, jungle scenes and rivers taking over Alan Parrish's living room. Nora herself was caught up as she tries to save her niece and nephew, who had found themselves trapped in the game as well. There was a running river through the house with jungle weeds and crocodiles, while monkeys jumped into the back of Nora's car, causing havoc in the town as elephants, tigers, and the dreaded hunters stalked their prey. The final scene in the new Jumanji could mean that for the inevitable sequel, the group may be forced to tackle fearsome beasts in their own realm, rather than by being transported into the game world. This could also mean the teenagers will be acquainted with their avatars in the flesh, forming an incredible super team to take down the evils which plague the Jumanji world, allowing the video game to be completed once and for all. With a third in the new Jumanji world incredibly likely given the star power of Johnson and his cohorts, this could be the beginning of one of the best throwbacks of all time to the original film and novels.